I've opened up ODP 06, a simple doc.odp that we were using in the last video. And to pick up from where we left off in the last video, I'm going into Slideshow, Slideshow Settings, and down here at the bottom where we have multiple displays. This is inactive. To make this active, I need to change the type to default or auto. We're using default. And down here where it says presentation display, the default is the external display too. This would be for the projector, or in this case, a second monitor connected to my computer. On my laptop screen will show a console, and we'll look at that in a minute, and the presentation will show up in the external monitor. Clicking the drop down, we could have the display show on display 1 and the console on the external monitor, or we can have the presentation show on all the displays. I'm going to leave this with the default. I'm going to turn off the navigator and press OK. Now I'm going to start the slideshow. Up to now, I've gone into slideshow, start from first slide to start my slideshow. I do want to mention that one of the volunteers that helps create the LibreOffice software does watch these videos. Specifically, he works on the toolbars, and from time to time, he'll send me a tweet asking me what do I think of a new toolbar layout, which is great. But when I was starting my slideshow by going into slideshow, start from first slide, more than just showing you another way to do it, I got a tweet asking me why I wasn't using the shortcut on the toolbar. And what he was referring to is right here, start from first slide. And there's also a button for start from the current slide, as well as to open up that format page slide. We used this at the beginning when we got rid of the dark bars that were on our screen. Now, these are the only buttons we've used on the standard format. We also looked here on the presentation bar. We had add a new slide that added it to the slide pane. We've got remove a slide, slide layout. That's the same thing that we see right here in our sidebar. And the last one is duplicate slide, so we don't have to go into insert duplicate slide. When I was talking about the slide pane earlier, I should have mentioned all those. So I did want to mention that. Thank you, Jay, for the tweet, and also thank you for working so hard on those toolbars. I will start from the first slide. And we see that we are recording the external display because it's showing our presentation. If I come down and press this button, here is the console that I was mentioning that shows up on our laptop. This is to help the presenter get a little more information about what is going on in the presentation. On the left here, we've got the slide that the audience is looking at through the projector. This is our next slide coming up. Down at the bottom, we can press the arrow next, arrow previous. We've got some notes. We haven't talked about notes yet, but pressing that would show us the notes for this slide. Going into the slides, this shows us all the slides we have, at least in this case. Going to the next slide, I'm pressing my arrow down. The slide changes for the audience. This is where we're at. And we see the little outline around there. Down at the bottom, we've got the time of day and the time that this presentation has been going on. And when I change the slide, we notice that the time does not get reset as in the rehearsed timings. This is for the entire presentation. Pressing close, we'll close the slides. We also need to close the notes. I had that open. And we're back to where we started. The last thing down here is the help screen. And this, unlike many help screens, is actually very helpful. This shows us to left click, right click down, to go to the next slide, to go to the previous slide. Home and end will take us to the first or last slide. To get to the black or white screen, we can press B or W or period and comma. And there's some more information on here as well. There's one more thing that I want to talk about in this video. And to do that, I'm going to select one of these bullet slides. Actually, I want to select them all. So I'm going to hold down Shift and click on the last bullet slide. Then I'm coming over here to the master pages. I need to bring those up by clicking off and back on. And I want to change to the vintage master page. So I'm going to right click, apply to selected slides. And that looks pretty good. When I go into my slideshow, and I need to exchange this so we see the output. The first slide looks good. Going down to the bullets, we see that this brown does not fill up the whole page. A quick workaround for that is to go up here to the slide master. I'm going to right click on the side outside of this box and still on the brown, right clicking, convert to bitmap. Now we saw it just got a little brighter. We lost the gradient is what happened. Going back into the normal view by view normal. Now I'm going to start from the current slide. And we see that it fills a whole page. So that's a quick workaround if you want to use the vintage master page. I'm going to save this as file, save as ODP07, a simple doc, and save. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.